You sometimes get the question, is aerodynamics really important for trucks? Mm. You could think that this big truck and this light air is not really relevant for as a field. I mean, anyone who has been trying to ride a bicycle at high speed, they have appreciated that air resistance comes very fast with velocity, for example. It turns out to be a very large part of the losses that a truck experiences when driving. So that comes down to different effects on the truck. Traditionally, it has always been like the fuel consumption.
And also we can say that the aerodynamics effect is if you double the speed, you have a quadruple force, air resistance force. Then if you increase your speed by 3 times, it's 9 times higher the air resistance. So when you get up to speed, it has quite a significant impact on the forward motion of an object.
If you think about it, what really happens when a truck is plowing through the air, it really needs to displace the air around the truck.
Yeah.
And since the truck has such a big frontal area, that's a lot of air that needs to be displaced.
Yeah.
And somehow that energy needs to be taken from somewhere, and that will be taken from the truck's driveline.
So tell me then about the role aerodynamics has to play as part of Volvo Trucks' vision of towards zero.
In fact, it's one of the two largest sources of energy loss that we can get when a truck is running at highway speed. So equally large as the rolling resistance, so it has a huge impact to the energy consumption of the truck.
And the boom in e-commerce, of course, has had a dramatic effect on transportation of goods. Can you tell me a little bit about that impact?
That brings much, much bigger transport volume in the world, making the footprint of the CO2 emissions much, much higher. But the thing is, we are already trying now to mitigate that footprint as of today by making more energy efficient trucks at Volvo. The thing is, since the transport volume is increasing over time, it's even more important to mitigate this increased footprint from the transportation itself.
And that makes the challenge so much harder.
Yeah.
We have on ourselves to reduce all the emissions. At the same time, the demand is growing.
Yeah.
So that means that we have to fight from two ways here.
Exactly. Yeah.
Perhaps then you can tell me a little bit about some of the recent aerodynamic features that you have introduced, and perhaps a little bit about what you've got coming.
We launched the new FH facelift and the FM facelift, bringing much more into detail optimization. Being actually fed from this previous Volvo concept truck, we were looking into the front corners of the truck, which is basically the most important thing or feature of a truck, mitigating any flow losses when the flow is separated from the vehicle in high side winds, for example. But doing these small detail optimizations by mitigating and eliminating any split lines and gaps in those very sensitive front corners is really key to an improved aerodynamics performance.
It was really interesting to see really that a concept truck that we developed in the beginning, just the fact that we made it true to the current platform made it possible to, with not too much delay, we could actually introduce some of these concepts on the market. And that's more or less a prerequisite for how we should be able to work. I mean, we have early development, and there from there we can take out the most promising concepts, refine those, and then put them into production.
Exactly.
What about the recent European CO2 legislation? How has that affected your work with aerodynamics?
There are actually two different legislations that come into play in the imminent future. The CO2 legislation, as you mentioned, that puts a lot of constraints on us, and it puts a lot of challenges to us that we need to reduce CO2 emissions, and with aerodynamics being one of the main contributors to that, obviously we need to improve a lot on aerodynamics to get good results. At the same time, or in this time frame, we also have a new legislation on the weight and dimension side, which means that gives us a little bit more of a larger toolbox to how we should handle this. That gives us the space essentially to carve out shapes of our trucks in new ways that we couldn't do before. So this is helping us to move into the future with even higher energy efficiency.
In our current platform and historically up to now, we have only been able to detail optimize our existing platforms and trucks. But now with this weight and dimension legislation, we are now enabled to actually do some shape optimization. And that has much, much bigger impact to start with. Then you can, of course, implement detail optimization.
And that's because the trucks have always, or for a very long time, they have looked almost the same.
Yeah.
And that is just the compromise of all the different features that you need to incorporate into a workplace, yeah, which a truck is. So every manufacturer has the same constraints, so that ends up in very similar products.
And of course, Volvo Trucks is a global brand. Do you expect this legislation to kind of filter out globally?
I don't see really an alternative. I mean, Europe is a good start. We could say that we do the legislation here. We come up with the changes needed to be done. So for the rest of the world, it's a package that they can grab and take.
So I think there will be like a trickle-down effect to go global.
Obviously adapted for different markets,
of course,
because different markets have their different constraints in infrastructure and so on. But I'm pretty sure that it will come down to a point where this will be in one form or another global. Yeah.
What different aerodynamic challenges do you have when it comes to aerodynamics and electric trucks?
Yeah, I would say the energy storage is one thing. We do have the same amount of energy in our tanks, in fuel tanks as of today, but the energy density and the storage when we are bringing the battery packs onto the chassis, that might actually be a bit less due to the heavy weight of it. The weight of it itself would actually bring much, much more attention to the aerodynamics optimization, because if it's a heavier truck, of course, then that would increase the rolling resistance, and then the aero resistance would actually need to be even further developed and improved in order to actually offset this increased rolling resistance.
Yeah, and it's also this thing with route optimization. I mean, typically with diesel trucks, the range question is not really something that spurs up all the time. Now, customers need to adopt and adjust to a new kind of reality in which charging times and range is becoming two main parameters for route optimization, that it hasn't been in the same way as before.
And also when it comes to the weather dependency and the route planning, how the weather is acting on the vehicle from a daily basis. Is it a headwind today or is it actually tailwind? That would actually make a huge difference in the performance of the vehicle and the range, as you say.
And that is really something that has changed a little bit our perspective on the aerodynamic side, how we develop our trucks. It used to be one thing when we're talking about diesel trucks. Now we have to look at a larger variety of wind conditions, for example, because we need to take into account not just the average fuel consumption that you would have over the lifetime of the vehicle, but rather what will happen today.
Yeah.
What is the wind like today? What is my range today?
I think traditionally there's always been a bit of a debate about weight and aerodynamics. How can customers find the right balance between weight and aerodynamics for optimum energy efficiency?
We can start by saying that the aerodynamic resistance of a truck is always the same, regardless of if it's loaded down completely or if it's only half loaded. It's more or less the same. And then you could ask yourself the question, the added weight that I get from some aerodynamic devices, will the aerodynamic improvement that gives, will that be more than what I add weight? When we look at our products and our aerodynamic accessories that we have, we can see through calculations that they always pay off in that sense.
What do you see the future holding for aerodynamics at Volvo Trucks?
We touched upon it before. I mean, all the constraints that are removed by the change of weight and dimension legislation, that just opens up a completely new portfolio of what can be done. And that really puts a new perspective on how the research and development is being conducted at our company today, with the introduction of simulations, for example. Yeah. That is an ever-growing field, and it's completely not saturated when it comes to efficiency of simulation. So for every year, we see a pretty large increase in computational performance, and that really helps us to come up with new ideas. And the feedback loop from where what we can do as an idea and how that really comes out as a performance increase, that can be done on a day-to-day basis, more or less.
In the past, it was more of a physical verification and development. Now we are turning more into the virtual verification and development, because it's much faster pace. The lead times of projects would actually be reduced, and we will have more product updates for the customers to enjoy.
With the resources that we have, we could toss and turn every little piece of the truck and see where can we gain some extra performance. This is more or less made possible by this technology change, and this is what we do.
Yeah, and not to mention the possibilities of virtual development is really the visualization of the flow, because in wind tunnel testing, you hardly run with smoke in order to see how the flow is actually acting. You see the numbers. Is it decreasing or increasing? In virtual tools, those visualization possibilities are enormous. Mm. You can actually get into whatever detail you want to that you could not possibly do in testing, in order to actually get much more knowledge about the flow field. And then based on the flow field knowledge, we know exactly what to do instead of trial and error type of development.
And at the same time, if we find something that we look and see is really better, we can find also from simulations why it is better.
Yeah, exactly.
And this is really speeds up the development loop.
Yeah.
So with the use of virtual simulations and new features that you've got coming in, how is this going to impact your customers in the future?
I think we're back to the question that we had in the beginning also. It will affect their, if they have a diesel truck, it will affect their fuel consumption quite dramatically. It will impact the range of a battery electric truck, and it will lower the emissions from the truck from an environmental aspect. Even if we're moving over from fossil fuels to something more sustainable, the electric energy that we have, the capacity in the world of electric energy, will not be a surplus for a long time anyway. So we need to keep every little electron still. Used to be droplets of fuel, now it's electrons that we need to save.
Yeah, that's why we're making these energy efficient trucks.